Well, first of all, thought that was an exciting game. I thought Omaha's a really good team. A lot of respect for them. They're a good group. They're going to be at the top of the standings at the end of the year. They really impressed me. I think Coach Hansen's doing a great job. Felt like we played okay. I was a few too many turnovers and some things that we'd like to take out of the game. But overall, good team win, found a way to win, kept some separation in that second half, and came out with a W.
How'd you keep Zach Jackson out of the game? I mean, not out of the game, but I mean, 13 points below his average. He was one of eight.
Yeah, Tevin King did a phenomenal job individually. He was extremely competitive, really limited his touches, and then made sure on every opportunity he took his rhythm away. I thought Tevin's effort defensively really stood out to me. And then as a group, it was something that we knew we were going to need to do to be successful. And Zach's had some great games against us. He's one of the elite players in this league. So we're just fortunate that we're able to keep him under wraps a little bit.
How would you assess Mike's game? He didn't make a lot of, I mean, he took a lot of shots. He missed a lot of shots, but a lot of dunks. He had a career high in assists, I think. Played really well on defense. I mean, he had another game where he impacted it, obviously, tremendously, but maybe a little differently than he does sometimes.
Yeah, I thought for Mike, I mean, that wasn't a very good shooting performance at all. I mean, I think there's a lot of times he was really aggressive driving to the rim and finishing dunks and then some post-ups around the basket. But overall, from what we've come to expect from him with his touch, he doesn't often go 2 for 9 from three. He doesn't often go 3 for 7 from the foul line. And there's even some plays around the rim we're used to him finishing. So, but to his credit, goodness, he was a beast on the glass. He attacked the rim off the dribble. He had some really big passes. And even out of the post, I thought there were some hockey assists that he had, too, that he didn't get credit for in the stat line, and some blocks around the rim. So he's still taking us he's still finding ways to impact the game in a lot of ways. And then we say that, and he had 33 and 16, and we're talking about, you know, he didn't shoot it quite as well as he normally does.
And he's still shot 9 from beyond the arc, but is it a thing where if it's not working for him and he has to just do those things closer to the rim? Do you have to tell him that, or does he know just to do that?
Yeah, I think he knows. He's got great feel and instincts and a basketball IQ, and, you know, at the same time, we trust him to take whatever shot. He's proven the ability to make all of them, and he gets them going, and he can get on a wave. So, you know, he's got to use his decision making and his intelligence. We trust him to make the right plays, and we're confident that he'll take the shots that make us win. He's proven to do that.
He said you don't like the pump fake too much, but it worked pretty well tonight.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of times when Mike catches on the perimeter and shot fakes, the other team collapses their entire defense on him, and it's like landmines as he's trying to go through the paint, and that's where we've got some of those charges. But if he can find a way to do it and rip down the rim like he was doing tonight and not pick up charges, I guess I'll have to be a little bit more okay with it than I've been.
How big was that stretch where he went baseline and got the dunk, and you got him on the dunk in transition right after that to kind of flip the momentum of the game?
Yeah, huge. And, I mean, that was an awesome crowd for us today. I mean, it's nice with the doubleheader, certainly, but I thought there was a lot of energy in the gym, and I thought that those two plays, I mean, you get dunks and off great passes and unselfish play, and that rallies the crowd. Those baskets are worth a lot more than 2 points on the scoreboard because they just give you so much energy and bring that energy into the gym.
Awesome. Thanks, guys.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, David's a tremendous scorer. I mean, he's proven that early in his career already. We need him to be aggressive. I felt like early in the game he wasn't as aggressive as I'd like him to be, and he was kind of out of rhythm. It's not often with him either. You know, I think he missed his first 4 looks at the goal, and then he kind of got going a little bit. But he continues to develop, and we'll continue to challenge him in a lot of ways defensively, as a guy who's a playmaker as well, because there's a lot more that he's capable of than just being a scorer or even a shooter at times.
He's got to stop playing with his headband.
Yeah, I wasn't real thrilled with that at the end there. He was fixing it, and that equated an extra 3 points for them.
You almost got a technical foul on that. The ref thought you were yelling at him.
He did? I had a few other things to say earlier, so.